Good afternoon, and welcome to the 2023 Miss Massachusetts Teen Competition. Please rise and welcome to the stage to sing the national anthem our current Miss Massachusetts Teen 2022, Jenna McLaughlin.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's echo, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the lands of the free and the
At this time, please turn off all cell phones and other electronic devices. Really. As a reminder for the safety of our contestants and performers, there is no flash photography during the show. Please note the nearest exits, and also a reminder that there is no smoking anywhere on the school campus and no eating or drinking in the theater. Now, please sit back, enjoy the show.
And it looks like this. I like to dance and it looks like this. I like to pop and lock and hit you with a little bit of robot. Gotta hit it, get it, love it, beat it, get a little silly with the lyrical ridiculousness. I like to shake a leg. I like to knock my head. I like to walk into a party with a few a little move goes a long way, like a slow train running in the hallway. It's your way, my way, all day. My kind of magic is automatic. I feel like dancing, I feel like dancing. Even if it's raining, I'm not complaining. I feel like dancing, I feel like dancing. I feel like dancing, I feel like dancing.
Contestant one, Dana Moon Ott.
14-year-old student of Duxbury, Massachusetts. I am an at-large contestant, and my community service initiative is inspiring individuality.
Contestant two, Anastasia Rose.
15-year-old at-large contestant. I attend Old Colony. My community service initiative is staying strong, staying strong for others. Contestant number two, Anastasia Rose.
Contestant three, Layla Hosslander.
A 15-year-old freshman attending Minnetonka Regional High School with a community service initiative, Active Minds. I am Miss Hamden County's team.
Contestant 4, Faith O'Hanlon.
A junior at Bishop Ian High School competing as Miss Southeastern Massachusetts 15. My community service initiative is entitled Hope for Hearts, bringing advocacy and awareness to heart disease. I am Faith O'Hanlon.
Contestant 5, London Grove.
Representing the South Coast, I am 17-year-old junior attending Bishop Sang High School with a community service initiative, I Survive Supporting Survivors of Sexual Assault. I am contestant number 5, London Brown.
Contestant 6, Victoria Lynn Santos.
A 16-year-old from East Hampton representing the Four Hamptons. My community service initiative is Food for Thought, Food Insecurity, Action, and Awareness. I am contestant number 6, Victoria Lynn Santos.
Contestant 7, Kayla O'Hara.
Good evening, everyone. I am a 17-year-old senior at Bridgewater-Rainham Regional High School, currently Miss Worcester County's teen with a community service initiative of the Cleanup Crew. Live life cleaner, make your earth greener. I am Kayla O'Hara.
Contestant 8, Mia Mitchell.
An 18-year-old senior attending Silver Lake Regional High School with the Community Service Initiative of Lend a Hand, Give a Can, Fighting Hunger in Our Communities. I am your Miss Lakeville's team, contestant number 8, Mia Mitchell.
Contestant 9, Summer Sky Ramos.
A 17-year-old senior attending Fairhaven High School with the Community Service Initiative of Your Mind Matters, Breaking the Stigma Around Mental Health. I am Miss Whitman's team, Summer Ramos.
Contestant 10, Erica Parks.
Miss Boston's teen and a high school junior from North Andover, Massachusetts. My community service initiative is Pause for Cause, helping animals in need. I am contestant number 10, Erica Parks.
Smile with your hips, smile with your hips. My kind of magic is automatic. I feel like dancing. I feel like dancing. Even if it's raining, I'm not complaining. I feel like dancing. 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 I feel like dancing.
Contestant 11, Madison Matthews.
A 15-year-old freshman from Ludlow, Massachusetts, with the Community Service Initiative of Stop the Stigma, Not Everyone Learns the Same. I am your Miss East Long Meadows teen, Madison Matthews.
Contestant 12, Summer Raimondo.
My name is Summer Raimondo. I'm a 16-year-old junior from Chicopee, Massachusetts. I'm an at-large candidate representing the Connecticut River Valley and with a CSI of Be a Sport. Again, my name is Summer Raimondo, contestant number 12.
Contestant 13, Jamie St. Ange.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jamie St. Ange. I am a 17-year-old junior attending Fairhaven High School. My community service initiative is entitled No Time for Lyme, Lyme Disease Awareness and Prevention, and I am Miss New Bedford's team.
Contestant 14, Julie Liuzza.
A 17-year-old junior attending St. Mary's in Lynn, proudly representing the North Shore as an at-large candidate with my community service initiative, Two Thumbs Up, incorporating ASL into everyday life. I am Julie Liuzza.
Contestant 15, Emma Gibney.
A 17-year-old junior attending New Bedford High School with a community service initiative of Stay, Start the Awareness Young, Suicide Prevention. I am your Miss Blackstone Valley's teen, candidate number 15, Emma Gibney.
Contestant 16, Katie Thomas.
A 13-year-old Cuff Middle School student from Fallbrook, Massachusetts with a community service initiative, Suffering in Silence, helping make sure no one has to go through mental illness alone. Representing Eastern Mass, contestant 16, I am Katie Thomas.
Contestant Contestant 17, Peyton Shepherd.
I am a 17-year-old junior attending Bristol Plymouth Regional Technical High School. My community service initiative is Your Future is Yours. What you're born into does not define you. I am the current Miss Freetown's teen. I am contestant number 17, Peyton Shepherd.
Contestant 18, Sydney Drugan.
A 16-year-old sophomore from Westfield, Massachusetts, with a community service initiative of Save the Bees. I am Miss Western Massachusetts Teen, contestant number 18, Sydney Drugan.
Contestant 19, Lillian Annette Rankin.
A 16-year-old sophomore at Silver Lake Regional High School with CSI of Arts for All, turning color into confidence. Holding the title of Miss Cape Cod Teen 2023, I am Lillian Annette Rankin.
Contestant 20, Nigeia Montero.
Hello everyone, I am a 16-year-old junior attending Old Rochester Regional High School with a community service initiative entitled You Control Your Own Destiny, Youth Empowerment. I am your Miss Fall Rivers Teen, Contestant 20, Nigeia Montero.
I like to dance and it looks like this.
I like to dance and it looks like this.
Yeah, looking good. We like to dance and it looks like this. Come on. Smile with your hips, smile with your hips, smile with your hips. My kind of magic is automatic. I feel like dancing. I feel like dancing. Even if it's raining.
Now please welcome our MC for this afternoon, Miss Massachusetts 2011, Molly Whalen Noonan.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Miss Massachusetts Teen. Thank you so much, ladies. We'll see you all in a little bit. Weren't they fantastic? Thank you so much to Miss Massachusetts 2013, Amanda Narciso Pont and her fantastic dancers from Spotlight Dance Studio for choreographing today's show, producing today's show. I just want to give a special shout out to all of our dancers, Kaylee, Ella, Anna, Isabella, Brianna, Madeline, Kayla, and Naya. You'll be seeing them later on. Thank you so much, dancers. Wow, you are in for an exciting night. Is this anyone's first pageant ever, by a show of hands? Hey! All right, friends, you are in for a treat. Well, you just had an opportunity to meet the 20 contestants vying for the title of Miss Massachusetts Teen 2023. And some of you may know there have been several new changes to the competition this year, one with being the name change from Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teen to Miss Massachusetts Teen. But as you can see, these young contestants that hold local titles, that are at-large contestants, they are all truly, truly outstanding. As I said, as you may have noticed, some of our contestants competing here today are at large. Some of them do hold titles, but it's important to note that there's no distinction in the judging process between the two categories. We will point out some of the other changes throughout the evening through the different phases of competition. We have a really exciting show planned for you this evening, but our competition actually began earlier today with each contestant met with our panel of judges with a private interview. You will see a little bit of the onstage interview in just a moment. But first, before we get started with the competition, let's bring back the lady of the hour, the very last outstanding teen from Massachusetts. Please welcome Jenna McLaughlin. this like isn't fair. Okay. So Jenna, what would you say is the highlight of your year?
That's a tough one. It was really an amazing year, and it was such a dream come true. But I would have to say being recognized as a Teens in Action finalist at Miss America's Outstanding Teen. It was for my community service initiative, Together We Stand, Encouraging Kindness and Perseverance in the Next Generation. And it was such a dream come true standing alongside so many talented and amazing young women.
One thing that is so special about you, Jenna, is you truly do live your community service project. Backstage, she circled up all of the girls, and she went around and said something kind about each and every one of them, a special attribute, something that she learned about them. And I just thought that was so special. So not only does she talk the talk, but she walks the walk, ladies and gentlemen. She's amazing.
Thank you so much.
So what are your plans for next year without a crown on your head?
So I'm going to college. I'm going to be a freshman at Chapman University in California. I was accepted into the Dodge College, and I'm also in the honors program. And I'll be majoring in broadcast journalism and documentary filmmaking. I'm so excited.
Well,
West Coast, here I come.
That's so exciting. Now, we have a very exciting night. You're going to be crowning your next successor. What advice do you have for your next title holder?
I would say it's going to be a very exciting year, so take it all in. Take lots of pictures and videos, and just know that if the crown ever gets too heavy, you have 22 other amazing former Miss Massachusetts teens and I to have your back no matter what, and an amazing organization as well.
That's too true. Well, thank you so much, Jenna.
Thank you so much. We'll see you guys later. Bye.
Speaking of somebody that's always going to have your back, please welcome to the stage our reigning Miss Massachusetts, Katrina Kincaid.
Hello.
Hi, Katrina.
Hello.
How you doing tonight?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. How are you feeling about getting a new little sis?
You know, I'm sad because I love Jenna so much, but she does live 5 minutes away from me, so it's not like I'm going very far. I'll see her in her pool this summer a lot. So I'm so sad, but I'm just so excited for another teen to be in the sisterhood and get to enjoy all of the activities and all the events that Jenna and I did.
So exciting. So what do you have coming up? Anything new, exciting going on?
I am singing the national anthem at a Red Sox game. Woo! Next Friday.
You know, just a little old thing called Fenway Park, you know.
It was very, very fun. I've been begging them on Twitter to do that for the last 2 years, and finally they responded. So.
It's about time.
Yeah.
I think it's been a very long time since we've had a Miss Massachusetts in there, so good for you,
there
girl.
There we go.
Squeaky wheel Thank gets you. The grease. That's right. So while you're here, can you and I just, we didn't plan to match,
no, we
but
didn't.
There is a very special sponsor that I think we both need to thank. Let's just do a little turn.
My local girls know that I always talk about the sponsor.
Thank you so much to Marissa from
Lady
Black
Tie
for dressing us both this evening, as well as being the wardrobe sponsor. Another thank you to DRE Designs. And also Anita from Infusion for the evening gown sponsor. Thank you to all of our sponsors. Mm-hmm. You're going to take over for me now.
I am. I have to go place this over here.
Look,
don't worry. It's another Lady Black Tie.
We have you on tech crew. We have you emceeing. We put our Miss Massachusetts to work.
We do it all.
All right. So are we ready to get started with some competition here? All right, so we are going to begin with our onstage question with Group A, and I will have our broadcast journalist take over for me. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, each contestant will be asked a question directly related to her individual CSI or community service initiative. The CSI is meant to be something that each contestant is already working on and will expand throughout the state should she become our next state title holder. This phase of competition is worth 10% of each contestant's score. So first, we're gonna bring out contestant number one, Tana Lou Ott. All right, Dana. Hers is inspiring individuality, a passion for self-expression. Dana, what do you think that schools can do to encourage a student's self-expression?
Schools can do many things to encourage a student's self-expression. I think something that should be especially encouraged is a differing selection of extracurricular activities. There normally aren't as many as we would like, and I think it would be really important to introduce some more obscure activities.
Contestant number two, Anastasia Rose. Hers is Stasia Stays Strong, Staying Strong for Others, Helping Others. Your question is, of all the community service projects that you've been involved in, which one taught you the most and what did you learn?
All of them have taught me a great deal of things, but most of all, I always do my nonprofit every 2 years, and I have an event, and I teach the community about what I do and how I help raise money for people and those battling cancer. Thank you.
Contestant number three, Layla Hosnander. Hers is Active Mind, erasing the stigma around and educating others about mental health. Your question, Layla, is please tell us about the work that you've done with the organization Active Minds to raise awareness about mental health and youth.
So I recently hosted a car wash and was able to raise over $200 that I sent over to Active Minds, but I was also able to speak with educators from across Massachusetts about mental health education and what their schools can do to help our students.
Contestant number four, Faith O'Hanlon. Her CSI is Hope for Hearts, Heart Disease Awareness. And Faith, your question is, please tell us about Princess Valentine's Perfectly Imperfect Heart.
Yes, so when my sister went through her last operation, she had shared with me that the anxiety she was feeling before it was almost worse than the event itself. So I decided to write Princess Valentine's Perfectly Imperfect Heart as a source of comfort for children going through a similar operation. Thank you.
Contestant number five, London Brum. London CSI is I Survive, supporting survivors of sexual assault. London, how have you interacted with the Children's Advocacy Center?
Starting next summer, I will be a part of the Children's Advocacy Center, saying my story about how I was sexually assaulted and allowing children to understand that youth have been through it and that I will tell my story so that they can have a lending hand and I can be their support and their light, even as Miss Massachusetts Teen, to represent that you're never alone and I'm here for you, and I'll continue to do that.
Contestant number six, Victoria Lynn Santos. Victoria CSI is Food for Thought, Food Insecurity, Action, and Awareness. Victoria, how would you help stop the stigma associated with food insecurity in our communities?
I would start by talking about it more. If we speak about something more and start to accept the fact that it does happen more, then people will be more apt to be more open so that they can help support people who are experiencing food insecurity. Thank you.
Contestant number seven, Kayla O'Hara. Kayla's CSI is the cleanup crew, Live Life Cleaner, Make Earth Greener. Kayla, how can people be encouraged to be more environmentally responsible?
Well, just bringing awareness through social media, talking about tips of how we can help our environment and ways we can just make the world a better place. Thank you.
Contestant number eight, Mia Mitchell. Mia's CSI is Lend a Hand, Give a Can, Fighting Hunger in Our Communities. Mia, what have you done to fight hunger in your community?
So I actually have partnered with numerous organizations throughout Massachusetts, including 25 salons in Bristol County, East Taunton Elementary School, and I'm actually going to Lakeville Elementary School soon. And I am so excited because I have been able to raise over $500 and over 700 pounds of non-perishables.
Contestant number nine, Summer Ramos. Summer CSI is Your Mind Matters, breaking the stigma around mental health. Summer, what more can schools do to address our youth's mental health?
So, myself, as someone who was diagnosed with anxiety and panic disorders at a very young age, I feel like that education needs to start sooner because there's not a lot of parents and teachers who know how to handle kids who are struggling and they don't know the signs. So I definitely think that if I were chosen as Miss Massachusetts Teen, I would be able to go into these schools and work with these programs to be able to educate people about mental health. Thank you.
And contestant number 10, Erica Parks. Erica CSI is Pause for a Cause, helping animals in need. Erica, tell us about the work that you're doing with the MSPCA.
I have partnered with the MSPCA to pass a bylaw in my hometown of North Andover, Massachusetts. This bylaw I'm going to be speaking on at town meeting next Tuesday, and I'm so excited to be bringing in permanent change to my community. This bylaw will be preventing pet stores from selling dogs, cats, guinea pigs, and rabbits because these animals are often had a rough life before arriving at the pet stop and are often returned to shelters because they aren't brought to the best home. So I'm so honored that I've been able to partner with the MSPCA to make sure these animals are into their correct forever homes.
And that was all our contestants in Group A. Give a round of applause. Take it away.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Katrina. We will see some more of you later on this evening. So a few more sponsors to thank because we are nothing without our sponsors. One correction that I wanted to make from the program book, our tech assistants, Abby Ellis. It was printed Allie in the program book, but it is Abby. Thank you so much for coming for so long and making a weekend out of this to help us. Thank you so much. Thank you to Lorna Brunel of the Burtwood School for pageant prep for nationals. Steve Smith Photography, our pageant event photographer, who might I say, always gets the best crowning shot. So thank you so much to Steve Smith, Lisa from SoCal Glow Tanning, spray tan sponsor for Miss Mass Teen, Darcy Fisher for the donation of Touchstone Crystal gift card for the winner, and Creations by Nikki Lassiter Designs, custom design purse for Miss Mass Teen and Miss Massachusetts. Thank you so much. All right, so let's move on to my favorite portion of competition, the talent slash her story. Up next, you're about to see our Group B contestants in the talent her story phase of competition. This phase is worth 20% of their score. This phase has changed a little bit in the last year, and contestants may choose to display a performative talent, or they can delve into the brand new her story option, which is an opportunity to describe how their life has been impacted by one side of all four of the 4 points of the Miss America crown. These points are style, success, service, or scholarship. The contestants have written their own intros for this talent phase of competition. Kicking it off, we will begin with candidate number 11, Madison Mathias. According to professional dancer Shayna LaFleur, it takes an athlete to dance, but an artist to be a dancer. Performing a lyrical dance to Dreaming of You is contestant number 11, Madison Mathias.
Thank you.
Ethan Mathias. Playing the cello for 4 years in several orchestras and in her school's chamber elective, our next contestant welcomes you to join her in appreciating the versatility of the instrument as she performs a rendition of Eye of the Tiger. Here is contestant number 12, Summer Raimondo. That's contestant number 12, Summer Raimondo. Our next contestant loves training in many styles of dance. Tonight, she would like to invite you all to get up and get loud as she performs a jazz routine that highlights her playful personality to Jennifer Lopez's Let's Get Loud. Here is contestant number 13, Jamie St. Ange. Number 13, Jamie St. Ange. Musical theater takes it all. Singing, dancing, and acting. Performing a song and dance routine to Anything Goes, please welcome contestant number 14, Julie Louisa.
Times have changed, and we've often rewound the clock. Since the Puritans got a shock, they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to stem, instead of landing on Plymouth Rock, Plymouth Rock would land on them. In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Good authors too, who once knew better words, now only use four-letter words, writing prose.
Contestant number 14, Julie Louisa.
Wanting to give hope to those feeling alone and to let you know that you are not alone, with a special dedication to her cousin Tyler, reciting an original spoken word poem, is Emma Gibney, contestant number 15.
Stay. Stay, for you haven't met the love of your life. Stay because I love you. Stay for the beautiful sunsets you love the most. You know, the ones with the pink and the orange hues across the sky that was earlier blue. Stay for the late night drives to McDonald's with your sister, blasting Hannah Montana. Both of you knowing you'll probably have a sore throat in the morning, but neither of you really caring. Stay for the friends and the memories you haven't had the time to make yet, and stay for the friends and the memories you have had time to make. Because now, yes, now it feels like the whole world is against you, like nothing ever has or ever will work in your favor. And that may be the case now, but one day you'll have the best experiences of your life. One day everything will come together and the stars will perfectly align and the sadness you feel now will be gone. So stay, because the world isn't quite done with you just yet.
That's contestant number 15, Emma Gibney. Having to battle discrimination is difficult. Showing her interpretation of her struggle by dancing to My Power by Beyoncé is contestant number 16, Katie Thomas.
Contestant number 16, Katie Thomas. The Addams Family is back for a whole new generation to enjoy with the new blockbuster hit, Wednesday, which captures all of the creepy and kooky personality traits from the nursery rhyme line, Wednesday's Child is Full of Woe. Performing a ballet on point to Paint It Black, please welcome contestant number 17, Peyton Shepherd. Contestant number 17, Peyton Shepherd. Sometimes you have to bend over backwards to control your fate. We learn to truly live when we let go and just let be what will be. With her contortion dance to Que Sera Sera is Sydney Drugan, contestant number 18.
When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother, "What will I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be rich?" She said to me, "What will be,
contestant number 18, Sydney Drugan. Performing an Irish dance that she co-choreographed with her coach, Billy Petricelli, that includes both traditional steps with a few unique twists that represents her fun personality, is contestant number 19, Lillian Annette Rankin.
Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? If I'd been Cotton Eye Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? If I'd been Cotton Eye Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? We'll be right back.
was having some fun.
If I'd been forgotten, I Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? If I'd been forgotten, I Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
That's contestant number 19, Lillian Annette Rankin. Diamonds are the most valuable possession because they represent love, class, wealth, and purity. Performing an elegant and rich gymnastics routine to Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend is Najaya Montero, contestant number 20.
The French are glad to die for love. A kiss on the hand may be quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend.
A kiss may be grand, but it won't pay the rental on your humble flat or help you feed your meow pussycat.
Men grow cold as girls grow old, and we all lose our charms in the end. But square cut or pear shape, these rocks don't lose their shape. Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
Tiffany!
Cartier!
Cause we are living in a material world, and I am a material girl.
Cause that's when those louses go back to their spouses. Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
That's contestant number 20, Najaya Montero. How about a big round of applause? And guys, that was only Group B. We still got Group A talent to go through. I'm sweating. Whew. All right, let's keep things going. So we have some more sponsors to thank. Caitlin Lucas of KP Consulting, a brand new sponsor for 2023. Studio 2000 Hair Salon, Jack Barboza and Doug Ferreira, hair sponsors for Miss Massachusetts and Miss Massachusetts Teen for many, many years. Thank you, Jack and Doug. Kayla Medeiros, our lash sponsor and backstage hair. She was back there teasing hair while they were in the group. That, like, they were all like bundled up. Jenna was giving them compliments. She's like, yeah, yeah, you're nice, but your hair's flat. Like teasing them backstage. She's on it. Thank you to Fairfield Inn & Suites of Somerset, Kerry Gendro, the general manager. It's our official pageant host hotel. So thank you for all of our sponsors. Can I get a vibe check? How are we all doing? I like it, I like it. We're gonna need that. Keep the energy going, because now we have health and fitness with Group A. So this accounts for 20% of the final score. This phase of competition is a time where the contestant shares her commitment to health and fitness initiatives. A contestant's discipline and commitment to being mentally and physically healthy is a key to success in all areas of life. A special note about the outfits the contestants will be wearing tonight. They were given the approved silhouettes from the Miss America organization and guidelines from production committee to select their outfits. The guidelines recommended that each contestant show off to the judges their individual style while remaining comfortable and confident in their outfit choice. Let's get started with Group A, Health and Fitness.
Don't turn away from the heart of the groove, from the way that we move.
contestant number two, Anastasia Rose. Contestant number three, Layla Hofnander. Contestant number four, Faith O'Hanlon. Contestant number five, London Brum. Six, Victoria Lynn Santos. Girls, come on. All right, so now we'll continue with introducing the people that have a very, and I mean, really tough, we always say that, but like this year's especially hard, very tough job of choosing our next Miss Massachusetts teen. So our first judge, I want to see all you guys too. Hi, judges. So when I say your name, stand up and wave. Okay. Hi, judges. Hi. Thank you. Energy, people. All right. Our first judge has held state titles in seven pageant systems and has competed at the national and international levels, has emceed and hosted numerous pageant competitions, and has also appeared on several network television shows. She has worked in the field of education for 27 years and is currently the Assistant Superintendent of Teaching and Learning for the Melrose Public Schools. She resides in Reading, Mass. Please welcome Jennifer Turner. An Emmy Award-winning journalist and current morning news anchor at WPRI 12 in Providence, Rhode Island, she was recently nominated for another Emmy Award just 2 weeks ago. Congratulations. She has worked in news throughout New England. Recently, she had the honor to be a broadcast journalism lector at her alma mater, Boston University's College of Communication. She resides in a beautiful in the South Coast region of Massachusetts. Welcome, Kate Walsh. Our head judge today is a former Miss Rhode Island and is now the state teen director of the Miss Rhode Island Scholarship Organization. She studied at the Juilliard School and has been an owner and artistic director of a dance studio for 25 years. She is currently working as a realtor while she's staying involved in many aspects of the performing arts. She has currently completed a book, adding author to her extensive resume. She resides in Cranston, Rhode Island. Please welcome Cheryl Cusick. Currently the executive director of outpatient services at Arbor Counseling Services, he is also an independent clinical social worker with a demonstrated commitment to leadership and direct service to underserved population. He holds a master's degree in social work from Springfield College. Residing in Worcester, please welcome judge number 4, Eric Rolden. And last but certainly not least, she was Miss New Hampshire's Outstanding Teen 2014, and at just 18 years old, became Miss New Hampshire 2016. At the Miss America, I'm not done. She's still going. At the Miss America competition, she won the non-finalist talent award as a vocalist and still performing as a musician in her free time. She is competing with her Master's of Science in Nursing and will become a hospice nurse following graduation. From Dover, New Hampshire, please welcome Caroline Carter. I'd also like to acknowledge our judges here today, Holly Dean, who so graciously stood up to model for us, always looking 10 out of 10. She's president of the Miss Massachusetts Scholarship Foundation, serving as our auditors once again this year, are Mindy Botello and Joyce Cardoza. So thank you to our auditors. All right, so now let's welcome the Queen of Massachusetts back to the stage, Miss Katrina. You're gonna help me out again with onstage question for Group B.
Why, thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Do we get fun music for this group, too? It's okay if not. They're fun enough. All right. We're going to start with contestant number 11, Madison Mathias. Her CSI is Stop the Stigma, Not Everyone Learns the Same, Learning Disability Awareness. Madison, in what ways do you think educators can be more understanding of students with learning disabilities?
Can definitely just be very patient with their students and really be open-minded to what they're going through. So when they see a student that is misbehaving or having a trouble in a class, they can try to understand what they're going through and what's going on in their head and why they can't focus on the piece of paper in front of them.
Contestant number 12, Summer Raimundo. Her CSI is Be a Sport, the Benefits of Participating in Sports. And Summer, your question is, beyond staying fit, in what ways can participating in a sport improve a person's life?
Besides from staying fit, there's also the social and the mental benefits of participating in sports. For instance, you can make lifelong friends on a team, or you can improve your endorphin levels in your mind and really stay healthy. And so there's just so many benefits to playing sports, and you really can't go wrong. Thank you.
Contestant number 13, Jamie St. Ange. Her CSI is No Time for Lyme, Education, Awareness, and Prevention of Lyme Disease. Jamie, as we come into the outdoor season, what are the steps that people should take to keep from contracting Lyme disease?
Well, a very common misconception of Lyme disease is that it goes away in the winter, and they do die down a little bit, but they're never gone. So right now is the peak time of getting Lyme disease and it being attached to you. So when you go outside, because this is the time everyone goes outside and has a great time and some cookouts, and you really have to put bug spray on and cover your entire body. I know it can be annoying sometimes when it's hot out, but your health is way more important.
Contestant number 14, Julie Luiza. Her CSI is Two Thumbs Up, incorporating ASL into everyday life. And Julie, what are the overall benefits of teaching American Sign Language in schools?
I think the overall benefit is definitely being more inclusive. You never want to leave a student out if they don't understand the language they're learning. So if everyone in the United States learns the basics of ASL, everyone can talk to one another and everyone can be part of the community. Thank you.
Contestant number 15, Emma Gibney. Her CSI is STAY, Start the Awareness Young Suicide Prevention. Emma, your question is, what community resources are available for young people struggling with mental health issues?
One of the biggest resources that I always give people when they are telling me that they are struggling with mental health issues is, first of all, to talk to a trusted friend or adult. These people can be your backbone to making sure that you are getting the help that you need. If you are in serious consideration of something like suicide, the 988 Lifeline and the HeySam text line is 100% beneficial to making sure that you get the help you need and that you can continue to fight and you can make it through it. Thank you.
Contestant number 16, Catherine Thomas. Catherine's CSI is Suffering in Silence, Eliminating the Stigma Associated with Mental Health Issues. Catherine, how can social media be used in positive ways to support teens struggling with mental health issues?
I think social media can be used in a positive way by just making sure everyone has a place to go so that nobody has to be alone in this world, no matter if it's a group chat, if it's a group call, whatever it is, just making sure everyone has somewhere to go and just has people to talk to no matter what.
Contestant number 17, Peyton Shepherd. Her CSI is Your Future Is Yours, encouraging youth to break the cycle of drug abuse and addiction. Peyton, how do positive peer relationships support students who have a family member with substance use disorder?
Having a positive friend or someone who is really supportive and passes no judgment is extremely important for someone who is struggling at home and has traumatic events. It's important to have someone that you can trust and know that they will be there for you.
Contestant number 18, Sydney Drugan. Her CSI is Save the Bees, the Preservation and Importance of Bees in the Environment. Sydney, how can people ensure that bees can thrive in the ecosystem?
You can ensure that honeybees can thrive in your ecosystem by taking care of them, and you can do that in many different ways. By eliminating the herbicides and pesticides that you use in your own lawn, it can even help their entire colony. That gets into their groundwater, and that's a big difference in their hive. It can eliminate up to 10% of the growing bees. So by eliminating even the simplest of things, you can help the bees as well as many other pollinators.
Contestant number 19, Lillian Annette Rankin. Her CSI is Arts for All. Lillian, how can the arts be more accessible to everyone?
One way that the arts can be more accessible to everyone is by people donating. The most important thing to do is understand other people's situations and how you are really blessed to be in the situation that you're in. Being able to donate art supplies to other people is a really great way to spread it to everyone. Thank you.
Contestant number 20, Najea Montero. Her CSI is You Control Your Own Destiny, Youth Empowerment. All right, as a peer mentor yourself, what tools and techniques do you use to inspire at-risk youth?
Communication is number one.
We often don't know what's going on in the lives of others. We often have to find that out, and not by others, but by the person themselves. Dig deep. Understand who they are, not how people think of them. Get to know them yourself. Understand their battles and fight it with them. Teach them that you're always there by your side and that they have other people who care about them to get them through their struggle. As a community, we can do this together. Thank you.
And that concludes onstage conversation for Group B. Molly.
Thank you so much, Miss Massachusetts, for how many more days? Another month or two? Another month? All right, well, we hope to see you all at the Miss Massachusetts pageant this June in Worcester. A few more sponsors to thank. Big thank you to the McLaughlin family, Jenna's parents, for everything you have done this year, but also for all the snacks backstage. The cookies are really, really good. Thank you for that. So I say this all the time, but the families mean so much to our organization, and it's really a testament to the Miss Massachusetts Board and the organization as a whole that so many families continue to stay involved. For example, the Matoza, Bostic, Fisher, Berube, and O'Riordan families, the Forever Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teens for their scholarship donations, Forever Miss Mass Teens, Brianna Bostic, Courtney Adelman, Zan Berube, Alyssa Matoza, Carly Fisher, Jordan St. Ange, Rachel Perry, and Tess O'Riordan for the donation towards the winner's official crown. So the formers bought the new crown for the Miss Massachusetts team, which I think is really special. And to put the crown in a beautiful home, a beautiful box, one of our former competitors' fathers, thank you to David Karen, the father of Molly Karen, for building the box for it to go in. They're absolutely beautiful. How are we all doing? You guys have great energy. This is awesome. Keep it up. So we are going to continue on back into the competition with the Talent Her Story with Group A. I like it. As a reminder, this is worth 20% of the final score. And we will begin with contestant number one, Dana Lou Ott. From Osaka, Japan to Fall River, Massachusetts, is city pop song Mayonaga no Door by Japanese composer, lyricist, and singer Miki Masuraba. Please welcome contestant number one, Dana Lou Ott.
Watashi wa watashi, anata wa anata to. Yube iteta, sona kimi suru wa.
Contestant number one, Dana Lou Ott. Beauty and grace with strength and passion. Here with her martial arts multiple weapons demonstration is contestant number two, Anastasia Rose.
Now when you go down, 'cause this is fine.
What's wrong with being? What's wrong with being confident? What's wrong with being? What's wrong with being? What's wrong with being confident?
Contestant number two, Anastasia Rose. Two of the most important lessons in life is to keep your head held high and your heart strong. This song reminds Layla of just that. Here with her rendition of Heart of Stone from the hit Broadway musical Six is Layla Hosnander, contestant number three. Contestant number three, Layla Hosnander. At this time, I'd like to take some time to thank one of our very special pageant sponsors, Daniel Gagnon Photography. Now, who here saw that cover of the program book? I mean, come on, glamour is back, baby. Holy cow, oh my gosh, I couldn't even believe it. Just wait till you see the one in June for Katrina. Whew, oh man. So exciting. But the 51 state leadership teams were told in January by Robin Fleming, the new chief executive director of Miss America, that glam is back and we want our program book cover of the state title holders to reflect that glamour. And Daniel, you went above and beyond. I mean, I must say, your subject, I mean, stop it. Like, it's just not fair. Like, I shouldn't be allowed to stand on the same stage as her. But like, unbelievable. Thank you so much to Daniel. We truly believe that he met the challenge 110%. And are we still loading up? So speaking of Six the Musical, how many of you saw Zan Berube just recently perform? Our outstanding teens, not only are they outstanding on stage, but they continue to be outstanding. Zan Berube, former Miss Massachusetts outstanding teen, is currently in the touring Broadway musical cast of Six. So if you didn't catch her in Providence, fly to like Missouri or something and try to go see her because she's unbelievable. And we are ready to continue on with the show with contestant number four, Faith O'Hanlon. As an accomplished musician, Faith is a two-time grand prize winner, achieving first place honors in Crescendo International Music Competition, representing the USA against 22 countries at Carnegie Hall. Here to perform Chopin's Etude Opus 25, number one in A flat major, is contestant number four, Faith O'Hanlon.
Thank you. That's contestant number four, Faith O'Hanlon. At this time, we would like to recognize a very special sponsor this year who is a true friend of our scholarships organization. Paula Moore was the co-executive director of Miss New Hampshire's teen program and just recently retired. Paula, thank you so much for your very generous donation to our scholarship account, and please stand up to be recognized. Paula. Oh, she's not here. Well, thank you, Paula. Three cheers for Paula. I didn't, but that's okay. At the age of 10, she was forced to keep a secret from her family that stayed hidden for several years. She found a song that helped her persevere and stay strong. Finally, telling her family the truth helped fix her pain and let the healing process begin. She stands today as a survivor and not a victim of sexual assault. Performing a contemporary dance to Truth Be Told by Matthew West is contestant number five, London Brum.
Lie number one, you're supposed to have it all together. And when they ask how you're doing, just smile and tell them never better. Lie number two, everybody's life is perfect except yours. So keep your messes and your wounds and your secrets safe with you behind closed doors. Truth be told, the truth is rarely told. I say I'm fine, yeah, I'm fine, oh, I'm fine, hey, I'm fine, but I'm not. I'm broken, and when it's out of control, I say it's under control, but it's not. And you know it, I don't know why it's so hard to admit it, when being honest is the only way to feel. There's no failure, no fall, there's no sin you don't already know. So let the truth be told.
That's contestant number five, London Brum. Performing one of her grandmother's favorite songs to sing to her when she was a little girl, here is contestant number six, Victoria Lynn Santos, singing Dream a Little Dream of Me.
Shining bright above you, night breezes seem to whisper I love you, birds singing in the sycamore trees, dream a little dream of me, say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you'll miss me. When I'm alone and blue as can be, dream a little dream of me.
Contestant number six, Victoria Lynn Santos. Choosing a song because it's fun and has a ton of energy, our next contestant will be performing a jazz dance to A Little Party Never Killed Nobody from the 2013 hit movie The Great Gatsby. Please welcome contestant number seven, Kayla O'Hara.
Either you're mine or you're not. Right here, right now is all we got. A little party never killed nobody. So we gon' dance until we drop. A little party never killed nobody. Right here, right now is all we got. Skeetin' ba-da-pop.
Contestant number 7, Kayla O'Hara. Mia has been singing before she could even speak. Today, she would like to share this lifelong passion with us all. Here singing Something's Got a Hold on Me is Mia Mitchell, contestant number 8.
Sometimes I get a good feeling. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. And I'm just gonna tell you right now. I really do believe that something's got a hold on me, yeah.
Oh, it must be love.
Oh, something's got a hold on me right now, child.
Oh, it must be love.
Let me tell you now, I got a feeling, I feel so strange. Everything about me seems to have changed. Step by step, I got a brand new walk. I even sound sweeter when I talk. I said, oh, oh.
Contestant number 8, Mia Mitchell. Liza Minnelli's Bye Bye Blackbird provided the perfect musical background for Summer to combine her love of classical jazz with a flair of Broadway. Please welcome contestant number 9, Summer Sky Ramos.
Blackbird, where somebody waits for me. Sugar sweet, so is she. Ba, 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 ba. Blackbird, no one here can love or understand me. Oh, what hard luck stories they all had me. Make my bed and light the light. I'll be home late tonight. Blackbird. Take a fly, a little blackbird, bye.
That's contestant number 9, Summer Sky Ramos. Finally, our next contestant will be performing a tap dance to a unique rendition of Rather Be in a costume she designed herself. Please welcome to the stage Erica Parks, contestant number 10.
We're a thousand miles from comfort. We have traveled land and sea. But as long as you are with me, there's no place I'd rather be. Chance, I would take it. It's a shot in the dark, but I'll make it. Knowing the love of your heart, you can't shame me. When I am with you, there's no place I'd rather be.
Contestant number 10, Erica Parks. And that concludes talent. Another round of applause for all of our contestants. A few more thank yous to Debbie McNally with assistance with our sponsor video during intermission. All volunteers, front of house, back of house, hostesses, we are absolutely nothing with our volunteers. We are all volunteer run, so thank you so much to all of our volunteers. The staff and students from BMC Durfee High School, the Tech Theater, you guys have been unbelievable. Everybody's always so used to running around, having to do everything. People have been able to sit back and relax today. Thank you so much, Durfee High School. And the custodial and security staff of Durfee High School. Isn't this a beautiful school? Thank you so much for having us. You guys ready to bring the energy back? You ready to bring the energy back? Yeah, that's what I like to hear, because it is time for health and fitness with Group B. As a reminder, this is worth 20% of their final score. Again, this phase of competition is the time where the contestant shares her commitment to health and fitness initiatives. A contestant's discipline and commitment to being mentally and physically healthy is a key to success in all areas of life. Please welcome Group B in health and fitness.
Baby!
Contestant number 12, Summer Raimondo. Contestant number 13, Jamie St. Ange. Contestant number 14, Julie Louisa.
Just started this fire down in my soul.
Contestant number 15, Emma Gibney. Contestant number 16, Katie Thomas. You started this fire down in my soul. Now can't you see it's burning out of control? Contestant number 17, Peyton Shepherd. Contestant number 18, Sydney Drugan.
Don't you understand, baby, baby, please? 'Cause only your good loving could set me free. Hey, hey, baby.
Contestant number 19, Lillian Annette Rankin. Contestant number 20, Najaya Montero. And that is Group B in Health and Fitness. So much fun. At this time, I would like to introduce our 2022 Miss Massachusetts teen, Jenna McLaughlin, to the stage to perform the selection that she sang at the Miss America's Outstanding Teen Competition in Dallas last August. Singing her self-arranged vocal rendition of Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles is Jenna McLaughlin.
It's all right. It's all right. Little darling, the smiles are turning to the faces. Little darling, it seems like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, and I sing, it's all right. Sun, 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 here it comes. Sun, 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 here it comes. Sun, it's all right.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Massachusetts teen, Jenna McLaughlin. I always love looking at parents in the audience while their child is performing on stage. Yesterday, I took my daughter, she'll be 2 in July, and it was the first time that she's really been around anything with the Miss America organization. And the second that we walked into Amanda's dance studio and she saw all the girls, her eyes just lit up. And I thought, oh no, I'm in for it.
got to start saving now. She threw a tantrum when we had to leave. No, me, go dance with girls. Go dance with girls. And they were all so sweet to her. So just watching Jenna's parents in the audience, I got like a flash forward to 15 years. I'm like, oh, geez. All right, get ready now, Molly. Is there any way that we could have a little bit of lights on? I just wanted to take a moment to recognize if there is anyone that is on a board for a local competition, if you could just be stand and be recognized. Please stand. There are so many young women who would not be on this stage if it not were for the people standing tonight. So thank you so much to our local directors, our local board members. You are the backbone of our organization. Thank you so much for all that you do and you continue to do to provide scholarships for these young women. The parents and families of all of our contestants, thank you so much for supporting them, driving them to endless appearances, rehearsals. A round of applause for all the families and parents of our contestants tonight. So now, are we all ready for our final phase of competition? We're almost done, guys. This is moving quick. At this time, we're ready for our final phase, the evening wear. This allows a look into how the contestant exhibits her own personal style, attitude, personality, grace, presence, and confidence in evening wear. Neither the gown itself nor the estimated cost of the gown is considered in scoring. The judges are considering their first impression reaction and a look at her composure, confidence, posture, and carriage. Evening wear is worth 20% of the total score. We'll begin with contestant number one, Dana Lou Ott. Dana is a 14-year-old daughter of Tanya and Christopher Ott of Duxbury, representing the South Shore. She is competing as an at-large contestant and attends Duxbury Middle School. Dana's career ambition is to be an actor, and her CSI is inspiring individuality. Please welcome to the stage contestant number two, Anastasia Rose. Competing as an at-large contestant and representing Cranberry Country, Anastasia is the 15-year-old daughter of Meredith Gubalt Rose of Acushnet. She attends Old Colony Regional Vocational Technical High School in the electrical program and aspires to be a licensed electrician. Her CSI is Stasha Strong, staying strong for others. That's contestant number two, Anastasia Rose. Please welcome contestant number three, Layla Hosnander. Layla is Miss Hampden County's teen and is the 15-year-old daughter of Shala and Carl Hosnander of Hampden. She attends Minichug Regional High School and her career ambition is to be an attorney. Layla's CSI is entitled Active Minds. Contestant number three, Layla Hosnander. Please welcome to the stage contestant number four, Faith O'Hanlon. Miss Southeastern Massachusetts teen attends Bishop Feehan High School. Her CSI is Hope for Hearts. A resident of North Attleboro, she is the 17-year-old daughter of Jamie and Ryan O'Hanlon. Her scholastic ambition is to receive a bachelor's degree in professional flight and receive her commercial pilot's license. Contestant number four, Faith O'Hanlon. Please welcome contestant number five, London Brum. A 17-year-old student attending Bishop Stang High School, London is competing as an at-large contestant representing the South Coast region. Her career ambition is to become a cardiologist. Her CSI is I Survived, Supporting Survivors of Sexual Abuse.
She is the daughter of Jennifer and Gary Brum and resides in New Bedford. Contestant number 5, London Brum. We next welcome to the stage contestant number 6, Victoria Lynn Santos. Attending East Hampton High School, Victoria is a 16-year-old daughter of Christina and Felix Santos of East Hampton. She is competing as an at-large contestant representing Hampton. Her future plan is to become a forensic biologist. Victoria's CSI is food for thought, food insecurity, action, and awareness. That's contestant number 6, Victoria Lynn Santos. Next up is contestant number 7, Kayla O'Hara. Kayla is Miss Worcester County's teen and is a 17-year-old student at Bridgewater-Rainham Regional High School. She aspires to receive a degree in meteorology and become an on-air storm chaser for a national network morning show. She is the daughter of Joanne and Shane O'Hara of Rainham. Her CSI is the cleanup crew. That's contestant number 7, Kayla O'Hara. Please welcome to the stage contestant number 8, Mia Mitchell. With a career ambition of becoming a broadcast journalist, Mia is the 18-year-old daughter of Hannah Dumrick and Christopher Mitchell. She is the current Miss Lakeville's teen and attends Silver Lake Regional High School. A resident of Kingston, her CSI is Lend a Hand, Give a Can, Fighting Hunger in Our Communities. Contestant number 8, Mia Mitchell. Next up, we have contestant number 9, Summer Sky Ramos. Miss Whitman's teen is a 17-year-old student at Fairhaven High School. Her CSI is entitled Your Mind Matters, Breaking the Stigma Around Mental Health. Her scholastic ambition is to obtain a master's degree in psychology. Summer is the daughter of Christina and John Ramos of Fairhaven. It's contestant number 9, Summer Sky Ramos. Please welcome to the stage contestant number 10, Erica Parks. A 16-year-old resident of North Andover, she is Miss Boston's teen. The daughter of Laura and Kenneth Park, she attends North Andover High School. She intends to pursue a degree in collaborative arts and become a professional actor. Her CSI is Pause for a Cause, Helping Animals in Need. That's contestant number 10, Erica Parks. Please welcome contestant number 11, Madison Mathias. Miss East Longmeadow's teen, Madison, is a 15-year-old student at Ludlow High School. She is the daughter of Danielle and Robert Mathias of Ludlow. Her CSI is entitled Stop the Stigma, Not Everyone Learns the Same. And her career ambition is to become a psychologist. That's contestant number 11, Madison Mathias. Next up is contestant number 12, Summer Raimondo. Our next contestant is the 16-year-old daughter of Amy Pat and Robert Raimondo and resides in Chicopee. representing the Connecticut River Valley region of Massachusetts. She is competing as an at-large contestant. She hopes to major in business in college, and her CSI is called Be a Sport. That's contestant number 12, Summer Raimondo. Please welcome to the stage contestant number 13, Jamie St. Ange. Jamie is Miss New Bedford's teen and resides in Acushnet. She is the 17-year-old daughter of Stephanie and Michael St. Ange and is a student at Fairhaven High School. Jamie would like to pursue a career in as a physical therapist or athletic trainer. Her CSI is No Time for Lime. That's contestant number 13, Jamie St. Ange. Next, we welcome to the stage contestant number 14, Julie Liuza. Competing as an at-large contestant representing the North Shore, Julie is a 17-year-old and resides in Saugus. She attends St. Mary's High School and is the daughter of Cindy and David Liuza. Her scholastic ambition is to study both psychology and theater. Julie's CSI is entitled Two Thumbs Up, Incorporating ASL into Everyday Life. That's contestant number 14, Julie Liuza. Next up is contestant number 15, Emma Gibney. Emma is a 17-year-old student at New Bedford High School and is the current Miss Blackstone Valley's teen. Her career ambition is to become a marine biologist. She is the daughter of Nicole and Timothy Gibney and lives in New Bedford. Her CSI is called STAY, Start the Awareness Young, Suicide Prevention. That's contestant number 15, Emma Gibney. Next, we welcome contestant number 16, Katie Thomas. A 13-year-old student at Matthew J. Cuss Middle School, Katie is the daughter of Sherry McAllister of Fall River. Competing as an at-large contestant, she is representing Eastern Massachusetts. She aspires to a career as a cosmetologist, and her CSI is Suffering in Silence. That's contestant number 16, Katie Thomas. Next up is contestant number 17, Peyton Shepherd. With a CSI of Your Future is Yours, Peyton is Miss Freetown's teen and resides in Dighton. She is a 17-year-old student at Bristol Plymouth Regional Technical High School who aspires to receive a degree in political science with a career ambition of serving in the U.S. Army and then the FBI. She is the daughter of Jenna and Stephen Prezzolo and Joseph Shepherd. That's contestant number 17, Peyton Shepherd. Please welcome contestant number 18, Sydney Drugan. Miss Western Massachusetts teen is a 16-year-old student at Westfield High School. Her career ambition is to become a geological engineer and a volcanologist. Her CSI is called Save the Bees, the effects of water contamination on honeybees. She is the daughter of Beth and David Drugan of Westfield. Contestant number 18, Sydney Drugan. Next up is contestant number 19, Lillian Annette Rankin. Miss Cape Cod's teen is a 16-year-old student at Silver Lake Regional High School. She is the daughter of Lorna and Christopher Rankin and resides in Plimpton. Her CSI is Arts for All, and she would like to study art and visual culture in college. Contestant number 19, Lillian Annette Rankin. Please welcome to the stage contestant number 20, Najea Montero. Najea is 16 years old and attends Old Rochester Regional High School and is Miss Fall River's teen. She would like to pursue a career as a cardiothoracic surgeon. Her CSI is entitled, You Control Your Own Destiny, Youth Empowerment. She is the daughter of Chantel Baptista and Wilson Montero and lives in New Bedford. Contestant number 20, Najea Montero. And that is that. So now let's welcome back our 20 contestants, and that concludes all phases of competition. Let's welcome them all back, and we will soon be announcing our top five, and then our new Miss Massachusetts team. Big round of applause for all of our contestants this evening. You all ready for the top five? Wait for a brief 15-minute intermission. Buy lots of raffle tickets, donate lots of money. We'll see you back here in about 15 minutes. We said glamour is back. Yes, we did. Thank you, Lady Black Tie. How is everyone doing? Well, welcome back. And at this time, I would like to welcome back to the stage our reigning Miss Massachusetts for just a little bit longer. Please welcome Miss Massachusetts Teen 2022, Jenna McLaughlin, singing She Used to Be Mine from the hit Broadway musical Waitress.
She is good, but she is hard on herself, and she's broken and won't ask for help. And she's messy, but she's kind. She's lonely most of the time. She's all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but used to be mine. And you're not what I asked for. Sometimes life just slips in through a back door and carves out a person who makes you believe all true. And now I've got you, and you're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two for that girl.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Massachusetts Teen 2022, Jenna McLaughlin. All right. You have seen the contestants compete in all phases of onstage competition, and we are now ready to announce our top five finalists. These are the five young women who have scored the highest in all phases of competition, including private interview, and these five names will be announced in random order. Deep breath, ladies. Deep breath, audience. Guys, I'm nervous too. This is my first time announcing a top five. This is so exciting. Okay. In random order, first up in our top five is contestant number 17, Peyton Shepherd. Next contestant in the top five is contestant number 4, Faith O'Hanlon. Next up, contestant number 15, Emma Gibney. One, two, three, four is contestant number 10, Erica Parks. And our final contestant in our top five is contestant number 20, Najea Montero. Congratulations to our top five. A big round of applause for all of our non-finalist contestants. You are all amazing. At this time, I will dismiss all of our non-finalists. Thank you so much for all of your hard work. We will see you back in a little bit. Thank you, non-finalists. Well, now this is so fun. I get to ask questions. All right, ladies. How we doing? Great, great, great. Do we need another big collective deep breath? Big into the deep breathing. Okay, so as I mentioned before, the 5 points of the crown, service, scholarship, style, success, and sisterhood, are the basis of the Miss America organization. So why not find out who our next Miss Massachusetts teen should be based on those 5 qualities? All of the questions in here were decided ahead of time. They are in no particular order. It is a fishbowl. They will be based on one of those 5 qualities. Are you ladies ready? All right, come on up, Peyton, pick your question. Style. How will your interpersonal skills and style make you a good Miss Massachusetts teen?
I base my style off of happiness. I try to wear bright clothing to make me positive. Just when I put on clothing that is bright and is happy, it puts my mood and it makes me go out to places and express happiness. I try to spread happiness with everybody so when they look at me, they feel a little bit brighter.
Thank you, Peyton. Next up, we welcome Faith O'Hanlon. Please pick your question. Thank you. Service. Outside of your own community service initiative, how do you plan to be of service to Massachusetts and the Miss Massachusetts program?
Service to me can be many things, but one of those is just being a kind, welcoming person. Acting as a role model in everything that you do is so important. So that is why I would act with service as Miss Massachusetts' team.
Thank you. Come on up, Emma Gibney. Sisterhood. How would you convince a skeptical potential contestant to become part of the Miss America Sisterhood?
The first thing that I would say is that I have made some of my best friends through this organization. Layla Hosnander, Miss Hampton County's teen, is one of my best friends, and I think making sure that people know all of the great benefits of this amazing organization is key to making sure that people understand that this organization can do so much for you, as much as you can do for your community around you. Thank you.
Thank you, Abra. Come on down, Erica Parks. Success. What do you feel that you want to accomplish during your year as Miss Massachusetts teen to make it a success?
My definition of success is being happy, healthy, doing what I love, surrounded by people that I love. So as long as at the end of my year of service as Miss Massachusetts teen, I am doing just that while having grown my community service initiative and having grown as a person, then I would consider my year a success.
Thank you, Erica. Come on down, Najea Montero. Thank you. Scholarship. As Miss Massachusetts Teen and a busy student, how will you maintain a commitment to your educational goals and scholarship?
First off, you don't hold this title as just Miss Massachusetts Teen. You hold this title as yourself. I'll be presenting myself as Najea Montero because that's who I am. Now, having a title isn't going to affect my life in a bad way. It's only going to make it better. I already do my service daily. I post on social media daily. I give back to the community every single day, with a crown or without a crown. So that crown being on my head is just an addition to my life, the greatness that I have already. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our top five finalists for Miss Massachusetts Teen. We will give our judges one final look of each of the contestants, beginning with Peyton Shepherd. Faith O'Hanlon. The third member of our top five, Emma Gibney. Finalist number four, Erica Parks. Our final finalist, Najea Montero. One of these young women will be your next Miss Massachusetts Teen. Congratulations, ladies. You are dismissed. Go kick back, relax. Your job is over. Go relax a little bit. We'll see you in a little bit. So exciting. It is now time to introduce some very special guests with us today. We are honored to have some visiting state title holders from our neighboring New England states. You might have seen some other people with some sparkly hats. Are you all making your way to the stage, or are you? Okay, come on down, state title holders. Oh, all teens coming to support their new sister or outgoing sister.
Hello, everyone. My name is Lexi Alcott. I am Miss Maine's last outstanding teen, and my social impact initiative, community service initiative, is called The Way I Dress Is Not a Yes. This seeks to bring awareness to survivors of sexual assault and diminish the common myths surrounded by sexual assault. Thank you for having me.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sienna Muccioli. I'm your first Miss New Hampshire's teen, and my community service initiative is putting the U in UNICEF. What I do is I work with children in New Hampshire and worldwide with UNICEF to help all of them.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jillian Johnston, and I'm your Miss Rhode Island's Teen 2022. My CSI is Wellness and Student Athletics, Creating Healthy Athletes, which attempts to break the stigma between mental health and athletic mental health. Thank you so much for having me tonight.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ginger Regatius. I am your newly crowned Miss Vermont's Teen. My community service initiative is titled Defying Limits, Breaking the Invisible Barriers of a Hidden Disability, and I work to break the hidden disabilities of a hidden disability. And I have a Well, I have an IEP, and I just kind of help it become more generalized. Thank you so much for having me.
Hi, everyone. I am Peyton Schroth. I am your Miss Connecticut's Outstanding Teen, and I am 15 years old. My CSI is Peyton's Promise Education Initiative. Peyton's Promise is my own nonprofit organization, and at Peyton's Promise, I give essential learning tools to kids in Title I schools across the state of Connecticut. Students are 25% of our population, but I believe that they are 100% of our future, and at Peyton's Promise, it's our mission to make sure that kids are getting the tools they need to obtain the education that they truly deserve.
Thank you so much to all of our visiting title holders. Thank you. You can go sit and enjoy the show. Come back on this way. You can come back this way. Or that way. No, turn around. Go that way. Sorry. That way. Right, 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 right. Yeah. Doop, doop, doop. Here in Massachusetts, we have a long and proud history of being one of the largest organizations for women in the country, and that's Miss America, of course. The young women we will crown in a very short time is joining a lineage of incredible women who have title holders who have gone out to pursue careers in business, broadcasting, politics, entertainment, counseling, education, and more, thanks in part to the scholarship they received through this organization. Please join me in giving a very warm welcome back home to many of our former outstanding teens.
Hi everyone, my name is Tessa Reardon. I am Miss Massachusetts Teen 2021, and I'm currently wrapping up my freshman year at Boston Conservatory at Berkeley.
Hi everyone, my name is Rachel Perry. I was Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teen 2019 and 2020. Thank you, COVID. Anyways, I'm currently a junior at Cornell University studying real estate finance.
Hello, hello, everyone. My name is Carly Fisher. I was Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teen back in 2017. Right now, I'm getting ready to graduate from Boston College with my Bachelor of Science in Psychology. But don't worry, I'm not going too far. I'm staying for my Master's in Developmental Psychology. So, staying in Boston. Thank you, guys.
Hi, everyone. My name is Alyssa Matoza. I was Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teen in 2016, and I just got back 3 days ago from my stint as a lead vocalist on board the Norwegian Dawn. So I work and travel and sing and do everything that I love to do after being Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teen. So.
Hello, everyone. We are going to go way back now. My name is Hillary Coelho. I was formerly Hillary Pavo when I was Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teen 2007. I currently live in Dartmouth with my husband and two children, and I work as a speech therapist in Fall River Public Schools.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jordan St. Ange, and I was Miss Massachusetts Outstanding Teen 2018. I'm also the current Miss Cape Cod, but we'll get to that in a second. I am graduating in like 11 days, so that's what I'm doing right now. And then about 2 days after I graduate, I'll be studying abroad in Germany, France, and Belgium. So that's what I'll be doing before heading to law school. And my social impact initiative is, oh my gosh. Don't worry about it. All right, and I'm introducing the local title holders. So now these are the local title holders from Massachusetts.
Here are local title holders. I do not have a list of names, so they will say their name and walk across the stage.
Caroline Holliday, Miss Bay State.
Sorry.
Natalie Yarnspeck, Miss Blackstone Valley.
I'm Abby Ricks, Miss Cambridge.
Ashlyn Mercier, Miss Collegiate Area.
Bridget Burns, Miss Commonwealth.
Celia Stafford, Miss Cranberry Country.
Madeline Hartke, Miss East Long Meadow.
Megan Sylvia, Miss Fall River.
Violet Joy Hansen, Miss Freetown.
Ashley Taran, Miss Hampden County.
Erica Correa, Miss Mayflower.
Tori Kalis, Miss New Bedford.
Chelsea Vaughn, Miss North Shore.
Olivia Taccio, Miss Pioneer Valley.
Maya Leonardo, Miss Southeastern Massachusetts.
Lily Deswald, Miss Taunton.
Bailey Tatro, Miss Western Mass.
Anna Rose Cicchetti, Miss Whitman.
Gabrielle Griffiths, Miss Worcester County.
Thank you, ladies. Do we happen to have the 50-50 raffle anywhere in the house? Oh, Miss Massachusetts. Do we know how much they're winning?
Yes, they are winning $220.
Ooh, $220. Here, you do the honors. Oh. I'll hold the bag.
Why, thank you. Okay, wait, but before I wanted to do this, I don't see her, but there she is. There's a little girl in the back who I promised I would wave to the next time I came up on stage. So, oh, hi. Okay, now for some winner of some money.
Everyone get your tickets out.
All right, you ready?
Big money, big money.
All right. 0004368. I heard a gasp. There was a gasp. Did that gasp win? Are you shocked that you didn't win?
Read it again.
0004368. Oh, that was a losing gasp. Okay, I'll go again. I'll give you one more shot. 0004368. Yes?
Yes?
Oh, you do got a lot of tickets.
You earned this.
Thank you so much for donating to our program.
Yes?
We appreciate you.
Do you want to tell these the winnings?
Yes. Yes? Yeah! And I'll take that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So just some more thank yous. Our state teen director, the head of this Miss Massachusetts teenship, Director Donna Klamkin, would like to extend a thank you to all of you for being with us today, particularly our former Miss Massachusetts state title holders and their parents and families of our 2023 state contestants. Thank you, as well as a family of our 2022 representatives, Janice and John McLaughlin. A round of applause for Janice's parents. Thank you for supporting your daughter as well as our program. And finally, all the board of directors, this scholarship organization is entirely run by volunteers, like I mentioned before. Thank you for all of your help backstage, hostesses, judges, hospitality committee, front of house, volunteers. A very special thank you to all of the staff and student volunteers at Durfee High School for their assistance. And we are honored to be the first outside organization allowed to rent this beautiful new facility. So thank you so much, everyone, for making this possible. Now, before we move on to the final portion of our show, we have to say goodbye to a very special young woman who served our state with pride during this last year. Please welcome, for the last time, Miss Massachusetts Teen 2022, Jenna McLaughlin.
Parents that I wanted to compete in a pageant, and now, after years of hard work, determination, and many times coming home empty-handed, I never gave up, and my dream came true when I was selected as Miss Massachusetts Teen 2022. 2022 started as the hardest year of my life as I was facing harassment online and in school. The Miss America organization gave me a voice to help other people, which in turn helped me. My community service initiative is Together We Stand, encouraging kindness and perseverance in the next generation. Well, I decided to take my own advice and persevere. And 4 months later in April, I became Miss Massachusetts Teen 2022. My main goal as Miss Massachusetts Teen was to show others that anything is possible if you never give up on yourself. As Miss Massachusetts Teen, I shared my story at libraries, schools, and organizations. I was featured on WBZ News Boston, interviewed by our very own Katrina Kincaid, sharing my journey of perseverance in my anti-bullying book, Roxanne Takes a Stand. I was selected as a Boston versus Bullies host for their internet outreach and education initiatives. The program has reached over 200,000 kids across Massachusetts and will continue to reach many more. I use social media to promote the Miss America organization. One of my TikTok videos surpassed over 500,000 views. I also received a personal thank you note from the Stomp Out Bullying campaign for my fundraising efforts. Throughout my reign, I've read my children's book, Roxanne Takes a Stand, to over 400 students. I also received a citation from Massachusetts State Representative Paul Donato to celebrate my achievements and to wish me well at Miss America's Teen in Dallas, Texas. At Miss America's Teen, I was recognized as a Teens in Action finalist for my work with my community service initiative. To all of my sponsors, Creations by Nikki Lassiter, Brittany's Boutique, Deary Designs, Lady Black Tie, Lorna Brunel, Studio 2000, Soka Glow Tanning, and Studio Lush, thank you so much. Daniel Gagnon, where do I even begin? You are so amazing and make me feel so comfortable during all of our photo shoots. I will hold the pictures you have taken of me near and dear to my heart forever. Thank you so much. My Miss Boston family, Emily, Molly, Claire, Carrie, I am so grateful to be a part of this incredible legacy and family. Thank you for always believing in me. Tanya and Mariana, your friendship and support this past year has meant so much. I love you guys. Tess, you are beautiful inside and out. Thank you for always checking in on me throughout this year and always giving great advice. Liz, although you were only my sister for a few short months, I loved every moment. Thank you for being you, for being a great friend, and for all of your support throughout this year. Bridget, you have been here since day one. I know I will always have you in my corner to support me, and our friendship means the world. Thank you to all of my sister queens, especially my New England girls, Lexi, Corinne, Jillian, Abby, and Peyton, for being the best. I love you all so much, and this year would not have been the same without you guys. To the Miss Massachusetts board, from taking me out to lunch and accompanying me while I chose my Miss America's Teen gown, supporting me at my send-off party, and much more, there was never a dull moment. Thank you to all of you for working tirelessly to make sure girls like me can have the year of a lifetime. Rocky, thank you for always believing in me and providing support, especially throughout my nationals journey and preparation, checking in and giving pep talks. Holly, from designing my national signs to always being so supportive, thank you for everything. Donna, so many girls in Massachusetts, including me, have had the opportunity to better themselves, find confidence in their own skin, and find happiness because of your tireless commitment to this organization. Your hard work does not go unnoticed. Thank you for believing in me, trusting my vision, keeping me organized, and allowing me to be unapologetically myself throughout this entire experience. Nicole, for the past 10 years, you have believed in me, supported me, and become family. I love you. Erin, you have not only supported my pageant journey, you have made me a better person. From coming to Dallas to support me, saving seats for my entire family so that they could watch me on the Miss America's Teen stage, to waking up early in the morning to record me at the Teens in Action breakfast. Thank you for being in my life. I love you. Katrina, I can't believe I've gone so many years without you as my mentor and friend. You are the older sister I've always wanted, and I love you so much. My family, for my entire life, you've attended my theater productions, dance recitals, concerts, and you've never missed a pageant. I cannot thank you guys enough for all that you have done for me. Mom and Dad, thank you for saying yes when I asked you to compete for my first pageant 10 years ago. This 10-year pageant journey would not have been possible without your unwavering support. I love you so much. To the Miss Massachusetts team, class of 2023, you are all so amazing and talented, and I cannot wait to continue to watch all of your journeys. To my successor, you are in for the year of your life. Enjoy every moment and take it all in. In closing, if your dreams don't scare you, they aren't big enough.
So if you ever have a goal or something that you want to do, don't give up. Keep trying, because eventually you will succeed if you will achieve that.
For the last time, I am Miss Massachusetts Teen 2022, Jenna McLaughlin. When I was 8 years old, I told my parents that I wanted to compete in a pageant. And now, after years of hard work, determination, and many times coming home empty-handed, I never gave up. And my dream came true when I was
Massachusetts Teen, Jenna McLaughlin.
All right, everyone, we are just moments away from crowning our new title holder. Let's bring back all of our teens for the show finale.
I could have my Gucci on, I could wear my Louis Vuitton, but even with nothing on, bet I made you look, I made you look. I'll make you double take, soon as I walk away, call up your chiropractor just in case your neck break. Ooh, tell me what you gonna do. I'm about to make a scene, double up that sunscreen. I'm about to turn the heat up, gonna make your glasses steam. Ooh, tell me what you gonna do. Ooh. When I do my walk, I can guarantee your job will drop. Cause they don't make a lot of what I got. Ladies, if you feel me, this your pop. I could have my Gucci on. Gucci on. I could wear my Louis. Taste. You'll never be the same. This ain't that ordinary. This that 14 karat cake. Ooh, tell me what you gonna do.
Massachusetts Teen 2023 candidates. All right, is Miss Jenna backstage? I have one more job for her. Is Jenna backstage? Could you do a special job for me?
I would love to.
We have some special awards that we need to give out. Would you get those results for me, please? So much. Okay, so before we get to the big one, we have some awards that we want to give out first. So first up, we have Pageant Planet's Online People's Choice Award winner, which is winning a total of $513.75. And that goes to contestant number 11, Madison Mathias. Up our Spirit of Miss Mass Teen winner, which is a very special award voted on by her fellow contestants. That goes to contestant number 7, Kayla O'Hara. Award and the winner of a $100 scholarship is contestant number 10, Erica Parks. Award winner of a $100 scholarship donated by the family of Zan Berube, Miss Mass Teen 2015, is contestant number 11, Madison Mathias, who raised a total of $846 for Spot Fund. Scholastic Achievement Award, which is a $100 scholarship donated by the family of Tess O'Riordan, Miss Mass 2021, and it is voted on by an outside committee. That goes to contestant number 15, Emma Gibney. The Pain into Purpose Scholarship Essay Award, which is a $200 scholarship donated by Jenna McLaughlin, Miss Mass Teen 2022, goes to contestant number 5, London Brum. The third annual Millie Perry Community Service Award winner of a $200 scholarship donated by the family of Carly Fisher, Miss Mass Teen 2017, goes to contestant number 8, Mia Mitchell. Evening Wear Award winner of a $100 scholarship donated by the family of Alyssa Matoza, Miss Mass Teen 2016, goes to contestant number 20, Najea Montero. The Overall Interview Award winner and a $100 scholarship donated by the family of Brianna Bostic, Miss Mass Teen 2009, goes to contestant number 20, Najea Montero. Congratulations, ladies. It is time. I'm going to call back the top five. When I call back your name, our top five, please come to the center of the stage for crowning. First up, welcome Peyton Shepherd. Not yet. Not yet. Our second finalist is Faith O'Hanlon. Our third finalist, Emma Gibney. Our fourth finalist, Erica Parks. And our fifth finalist, Najea Montero. Deep breath, everyone. Everyone. In a very particular order, the fourth runner-up and the winner of a $250 scholarship is Erica Parks. The third runner-up and winner of a $500 scholarship is Peyton Shepherd. The second runner-up and winner of a $750 scholarship is Faith O'Hanlon. Ladies, come down to the center of the stage. Our last two finalists, move on down a little bit. Come on down to the center of the stage a little further. I know, it's exciting, I'm sorry. I'm going to be very clear. The next name I'm going to call is the name of the first runner-up. Our first runner-up and the winner of a $1,000 scholarship is Najea Montero. Your new Miss Massachusetts team is Emma Gibney. Thank you all so much and have a great night.